This is my first look and review of the Divi 4 theme. If you follow my channel, you probably know that in the past, I've been a pretty big fan of the Divi theme. So how does Divi 4 stack up? I'm Tim, and this is Real Website Hints. This channel is all about helping you find the best online tools that will help you build your website easily. I look for the tools that are simple and intuitive, but still powerful. The opinions on this channel are my own, and the advice that I give here is the same advice that I would give if a friend asked me what they should do for their website. If you find the information helpful and you'd like to support the channel, use the links in the description down below. They cost you nothing extra, and they help me to purchase and test the products that I review and to create the free tutorials that I offer on this channel. So let's dive in and take a look at the Divi 4.0 theme. So what is the Divi theme and who is it for? The Divi theme is a tool for those people who want to build a WordPress website, but want more control over the look of their website than a standard WordPress theme offers. Standard WordPress themes have a fixed look that can usually only be changed by actually changing the code of the theme. Standard WordPress themes are great for simplicity. You simply plug in the content and your theme wraps that content in the look of your website. But if you've ever gotten a standard WordPress theme and you wanted to change some aspect of it, say the background color, or maybe where the blog title shows up on the page, anything like that, and you're gonna need to dive into the code and create a child theme and actually modify the code of that theme. And that's great if you know how to code and you're really comfortable with code, but if you're like me, code isn't all that easy to do. So what the Divi theme allows you to do is make some of these changes, but a lot more easily. With Divi 4, you can now style all aspects of your WordPress website. The Divi theme used to only allow you to build sort of single pages and design those single pages, or maybe you could use it on a single blog post. But now with Divi 4, you can use the builder and style all of your blog posts, all of your standard pages, the blog pages, the archive pages, even WooCommerce online store elements like the individual product pages or just what the store looks like in general. So this Divi theme is for anyone who wants more control over the look and design of their website without needing to know how to code. And Divi 4 still has all of the same powerful features offered in Divi 3. Things like A/B split testing, built-in forms for email signups so that connect to popular email list programs like AWeber or MailChimp and a lot of others. Contact forms, which have recently been updated to allow you to design content-aware forms. That way, when somebody puts in one piece of content, it can actually change the other information that shows up on the form for that person. And if you're looking to build an online store, there are now more robust features for WooCommerce that allow you to design what your shop and what your products look like. Divi has call to action modules, pricing tables, social media following modules, and automatic saving while you're building and designing your pages. Plus keyboard shortcuts, just like you'd have if you were using a desktop application. And if you want to learn more about some of those basic features that were also offered in Divi 3, I'll link to my Divi 3 review at the top of the screen. And once it's completed, I'll also link to my full Divi 4 review. One of the really exciting things that I see about the Divi 4 theme is the power that it can bring to websites with a lot of content like blogs. So now let's take a look at the results that I was able to achieve using the new Divi theme builder. I'm the kind of person who really likes design, but I wouldn't really call myself a designer. And with Divi and the pre-made templates that you can get, it gives you a really good starting point, and then you can go from there and modify things the way that you want. And that's exactly what I did here. So to create these pages that I used to test out the theme, I downloaded either one of the new theme builder templates from their blog, or used one of the page templates that comes with the Divi theme. The first thing that I tried to create with the new Divi 4 was a page for a photographer specializing in fire photography. I had some photographs that I had taken with different fire effects, so I thought it would be a fun test. For this test, I started out with one of the new Divi pre-made templates that I thought would fit the look of the content that I wanted to add. I selected the personal trainer page layout because I liked the sharp, distinct design, and I thought my photos would fit really nicely in that design. Divi has a lot of nice new page designs that can really help you get a quick start to creating nice-looking pages. To get started modifying the page design, I wanted to change the basic colors. And there's a new feature in Divi 4 where you can find and replace different design elements. In this case, it's perfect for finding and replacing a specific color across an entire page design. With just a few clicks, I was able to change this orange hero color across this entire page to a red color, which is the hero color that I wanted to use for this fire photography website. The one place where I found that this didn't work was in the shadows of these buttons. I'm not too sure why that didn't work. Maybe that's something they will address in an update, or maybe the color here was slightly different. Here's the final page that I created. I think it looks pretty exciting. And then I also used the new Divi theme builder to restyle the WordPress project pages. I think that for creating a business website for a photographer, Divi is a really good option. But if you just want to make a portfolio website where you want to be able to load in your pictures in bulk, I think that there's some better options for making a portfolio website. I think for designing a photography business website where you're really going to lead your viewers through a sales process, Divi is a great choice. But for making just a basic portfolio webpage, there's definitely some easier options out there. The next thing I wanted to try to do was to really dive into the new Divi theme builder and see what it can do for creating blog-style pages. One of the drawbacks of the previous Divi themes was the blog pages. It really just didn't look good. Neither the archive pages nor the single post pages looked very interesting, and I wouldn't really have recommended Divi for blogging. But now with Divi 4, you have the ability to create and design pretty much any part of a WordPress website. And so this really means you can style and design your own WordPress pages. So to get started with this, I started here on the Divi Theme Builder page. This here is where you can choose which designs are going to get assigned to which parts of WordPress. So for this, I'm going to start with a blog style design. And I didn't want to design it all from scratch because I'm kind of new to using the Divi 4 theme. So what I did was I went to their blog and they've got some free page builder designs that you can download, and I downloaded one of those page builder designs, and then I went ahead and started modifying it. And I can tell you, I was really excited being able to use the Divi builder to design my general blog pages. It's really exciting, and I think you can get some really great looks that you might only have been able to get before by using a standard WordPress theme where you'd have no control over it. But now you can control exactly what your blog pages look like. You can modify the areas around the main content, and you can put in either ads, if you want to use ads on your blog, or you can put in different promotions or different information. Now, what's great about using the Divi Theme Builder is that you can also decide which designs not only go to which part of your website, but also which designs go to either a specific blog post, if you want to be that granular about it, or you can assign specific designs to certain tags or certain categories. So this gives you a lot of options on what kind of content your viewers are going to see based on either category, tags, or even specific blog posts. And so I think if you're trying to turn your blog into a business, the Divi 4 could be a very powerful tool for doing that. With all the other features that are already built into Divi, and now being able to style and design specific tags or specific categories on your blog, you've got a lot of options to really turn a blog into a business with Divi. And this is something I'm going to be exploring further. So I'm planning a trip in the next few weeks, and I'm going to be creating a tutorial series on how to do a travel blog as an example of what you can do with a Divi theme. So if you're interested in that, I'll link to that in the description below and up above here on the screen. So I created a few different blog post designs. I think the first one here is the one that I'm most excited about, but there's some other options here, and you can see I've done a few different layouts. And I did this all using that one starting point from the Divi blog. And I think in the future, you're not only going to be seeing theme templates coming from Divi, but you're also going to be seeing it coming from third parties. So there's going to be a lot of options where you don't have to start completely from scratch on creating these designs. So I've talked about using the Divi 4 theme and a lot about the things that I've liked so far in this initial review. But there's a few things that I don't like about Divi and that I think that they should really be able to improve on. So one of the main things is working with the visual builder. Now, most of the time, the visual builder works great. But it can be a bit fidgety sometimes, especially when you have elements that are close together. Now, there is a workaround for this fidgetiness, and that is switching over to the wireframe view, and that can work really well. The only problem is that it's hard to know where you are in the wireframe view because it doesn't automatically add in the first section of the text or the name of the image inside the wireframe. This is something that some other page builders do in WordPress, and it'd be nice if Divi would add that. Another thing that I'd like to see, especially since I've been interested in making portfolio websites recently, is some improvement to the portfolio modules. The portfolio modules, the project modules, and even the blog post module, where you can see either a list of all of the blog posts or you can have them in a tile form. It'd be nice to have some more variations on what those look like. So for example, adding like a masonry grid look or just some different stylings for how the grids look. I'd really like to see that. Another thing as far as building your theme using the new Divi theme builder is I'd like to have sort of like a parts bin. Or for example, you could choose from templates for specifically for the header, and you could see a little thumbnail of what they look like. And it'd be nice if Divi made some of these pre-made headers for you, so you could just choose which kind of header you wanted, either on that page or for your entire site. And then if you wanted to, you could go in, use the builder, and modify them to look the way you want to. One of the other things that I would like to see them improve, especially for the new theme builder, is the ability to see a thumbnail preview of what the different templates look like. When I downloaded the theme builder templates that they provided on the Elegant Themes blog, they work well. The one problem I had was figuring out which template went to which look, because all of the templates, when I uploaded them to the website, had the same name, and there's no preview or thumbnail of what they look like. So it'd be nice, at minimum, to be able to name those templates for the page builder as you upload them. And then secondarily, it would be nice to be able to have a thumbnail attached to them so you could quickly and easily see them. Using Divi does take more effort than a standard WordPress theme, but it gives you an amazing amount of control over the look of your WordPress website, and you don't need to know how to code to make some basic changes to your website. This is my first look and review of the Divi 4 theme. So far, I'm really excited about Divi 4. It once again verifies my feelings about Divi that I had when Divi 3 came out several years ago. The developers behind Divi are committed to working on and improving this theme. With Divi 4, they've added the theme builder, which is a game-changing feature. They've improved the design experience and really made this a powerful tool for anyone who wants to have design control over their WordPress website. Several years back, I purchased the Lifetime plan, and I can tell you, I do not regret it. I think that it has been one of the best values for software in the website space. The pricing for Divi 4 is the same as it was for Divi 3, $89 for 1 year of updates and support, or $249 for the Lifetime plan. Both of them allow you to build an unlimited number of websites, and both have a 30-day money-back guarantee. If there are any current deals or specials on the Divi theme, I'll post them either in the description below or in the comments. So I'd love to hear what kind of website you're planning on building, and if you're thinking about using the Divi theme, let me know in the comments below. And it's my mission to help you, so please let me know in the description below what kind of tutorials or reviews would be helpful for you so I can know what kind of content to make in the future. And if you have any questions about the Divi theme or website building in general, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.